Thank you, Eddie. And I want to first of all thank everyone for being here today. We are going to have some very engaging comments from Ron Asana in just a minute. Before I get there, I just want to hit a couple of SIFMA points. I know my colleague Randy Snook spoke to you this morning, and so we're going to try not to overstate or drum into you all the different things we're working on, but we do like to take these opportunities just to talk about what we think is important. I also want to thank our friends at Thomson Reuters and Federated Investors for their sponsorship today of the lunch and the lunch presentation. So thank our sponsors for that. Now, I think as you've heard from the speakers today, and as anyone in the business knows, there's no question that the industry is going through a great period of transformation. Not only do we have the Dodd-Frank Act and other attendant regulatory initiatives culminating in the most significant legal and regulatory overhaul of the industry and the market since the Great Depression, but there's also a general industry push to improve risk management and enhance trust and confidence in the financial system. The private client function is vital to this effort, as you all hold the personal relationships with individual investors that put a face on the industry. I'd like to thank all of you all for joining us here today and for this conference and your commitment to staying abreast of what's happening in our industry, which demonstrates your commitment to client service. With hundreds of required rulemakings and thousands of comment letters, SIFMA alone has filed nearly 200 comment letters on Dodd-Frank. It's hard to overstate the level of change that has and is taking place. 5 years since the crisis, we know that financial firms hold much more capital, both in terms of quantity and quality. Regulators have a robust mandate with significant new authority and requirements from enhanced prudential standards to living wills to orderly liquidation authority. Market structure is being altered by new rules related to derivatives and Volcker. And just to follow up on Ron's comment, central clearing is a part of Volcker, and that took effect on March 31st. And compensation practices have changed materially. Now, while many in Washington and across the globe engage in a debate on the purpose and efficacy of virtually every aspect of Dodd-Frank, few, if any, can argue that the change it and other initiatives have brought is immaterial. Looking forward, we expect to see some of the most impactful new regulatory provisions from Dodd-Frank and other initiatives come into effect in this next year. I'd like to point out a few examples of SIFMA's priorities that are critical for strengthening the financial industry and therefore promoting confidence in our markets. First, as has been discussed frequently with many of you at this and previous conferences, efforts to enhance protections for individual investors through the establishment of a uniform standard of care remains a top priority for SIFMA. Clients' best interests deserve to be put first, and with many of you in this room, we are working to provide constructive and substantive input to the SEC as they try and craft a new uniform financial standard of care, uniform fiduciary standard of care. Likewise, just as there needs to be a uniform standard of care, so too should there be a uniform supervision of brokers and advisors. Thus, we have supported the establishment of an SRO to supervise RIAs. At the same time, we have made clear that we will not support regulatory initiatives, no matter how well-meaning, that would harm investors through increased cost and reduced choice. Thus, we have made clear to the SEC the problems inherent in applying the Investment Advisors Act of 1940 to brokers, and likewise to the Department of Labor on their proposed redefinition of fiduciary under ERISA. Just as we will work tirelessly to promote investor protection through a new uniform standard of care, so too will we oppose bad policy. Systemic risk management is another area of focus for SIFMA. We believe Dodd-Frank effectively ended too big to fail through the creation of a resolution authority for failing firms. And I might note, the statute very clearly eliminates the ability of the Federal Reserve or the federal government from bailing out a failing firm with the use of taxpayer dollars. As regulators work to finalize the processes surrounding this new authority to resolve failing firms, and more generally to implement capital requirements and heightened prudential standards, we urge them to coordinate across borders and recognize what has already been done and conduct proper cost-benefit analysis. Reasonable capital requirements strengthen financial firms and make them more resilient in the face of a crisis. But if these levels are too high, lending and credit availability will suffer. Third, is an example of SIFMA's work on market structure issues. SIFMA supports reform and compliance initiatives that strengthen markets and improve regulatory supervision. Over the past several years, we've seen significant changes to market structure as we adapt to advance in technology and operations. This change will only continue as we implement new tools such as the legal entity identifier and the consolidated audit trail. Establishing a system to track and report the full life cycle of trades you make on behalf of your clients is a massive undertaking that will require significant resources from the industry. And it's important that the industry work with regulators and the SROs to make sure that we get this right so it is a useful tool and not a burdensome tool to the industry and ultimately to our customers. To be clear, the industry has long been supportive of responsive regulatory reform, including many of the provisions of Dodd-Frank. While we've been quite clear in raising questions and necessary objections to policies and proposals where we have a different view, we have also made clear our commitment to work with the regulators to efficiently implement the new rules. And through our committees and societies, including the Private Client Group, the Independent Firms Group, the Private Client Services Group, the Private Client Legal Group, the Alligators Group, which I still am not quite sure what that is, but of the other groups that are here today, we are working with regulators to do just that across numerous markets, asset classes, and business lines. Yet while much has changed, we know that there is still work to do fully to restore faith in the financial system. Moving forward, SIFMA will continue in our mission to provide regulators with the industry expertise they need to get the new rules right and to provide a forum for the industry to come together and develop best practices that improve trust and confidence. But we must remember that regulatory reform alone is not enough to restore trust and confidence in the financial system. We know that our industry has a responsibility to proactively identify business practices that will make firms more resilient and enhance confidence with our clients, policymakers, and the public. Our board of directors has recognized that the industry must redouble its efforts to appropriately convey and exhibit by our actions to our clients that we are committed to bolstering their confidence in markets. Without this, the good intention of a rule or a regulation would be lost. That is our charge on behalf of our clients, and it starts with all of you here today. In closing, I would also like to thank our speakers, panelists, and my SIFMA colleagues who have taken the time and effort of making this year's program as strong as it is.